Hello students, welcome back to my channel. This is the last video in our series on effects of simultaneous change in the demand and supply on market equilibrium. In our last video, we explored how a simultaneous decrease in demand and an increase in supply would impact the market equilibrium. In this video, we shall focus on the opposite scenario where the demand would increase and the supply would decrease, and how the interaction of both these changes would impact the market equilibrium. So without wasting any time further, let's take a look. So this is a scenario where an increase in demand is equal to a decrease in supply. So when we say an increase in demand, we can see that the demand curve is shifting to the right from D to D1. And whenever there's an increase in demand, it would simply mean that consumers are now willing and able to buy more of a given commodity at the existing market price or at various price levels. When we talk about a decrease in supply, we see that the supply curve is shifting to the left from S to S1. A decrease in supply indicates that the producers are now offering fewer units of the commodity at the existing market price. We all know what are the various factors that would lead to an increase in demand and a decrease in supply. So I would not delve into that again. Let's take a look at how these changes are impacting the market equilibrium. The initial equilibrium in this market is at point E, with the price at PE and quantity at QE. When both an increase in demand and a decrease in supply occur simultaneously, their combined effects will create a shortage scenario in this market. Why? Because we know that the demand is going up and the supply is going down. So there's not enough for everybody to buy, and hence a shortage scenario gets created. The net effect on the equilibrium price would be to raise it, since there's a shortage, and a shortage would put an upward pressure on the prices. The effect on equilibrium quantity is ambiguous, as it will greatly depend upon the magnitude of these changes. In this scenario, the quantity is same because the change in demand is equivalent to the change in supply. So overall, what is the impact on the price? So the price has gone up from PE to P1. However, quantity is the same. Why is this happening? Because the increase in demand is equal to a decrease in supply. Now, this is a scenario where you would see an increase in demand which is greater than the decrease in supply. Now, let's say the market for this particular commodity is at initial equilibrium, which is E. Corresponding to that, we have the price at PE and quantity at QE. When there's an increase in demand greater than the decrease in supply, it will have a very significant impact on the market equilibrium. How is that going to impact in the market equilibrium? It is very evident that the price is rising drastically and there's some change in the quantity as well. Let's take a look at the price first. So since we see that the change in demand or the increase in demand is greater than the decrease in supply, the quantity demanded at the old price, at this price, is much greater than what is being supplied in the market. So in order to bring the quantity demanded and supplied back to the equilibrium, the price should rise. And when this price rises, it will discourage some consumers from buying the commodity or the service, and it will encourage some producers to supply more of it. So that's the overall impact that you would see on the price. So what is happening to the price here? The price is going up from PE to P1. Let's see what is happening in the quantity side. We see that the quantity is increasing from QE to Q1. But why is this happening? Simply because an increase in the price. So a higher price will also encourage the producers to supply more of this commodity, causing the equilibrium quantity to increase from QE to Q1. The quantity increases from QE to Q1. And why is this happening? Because the increase in demand is greater than the drop in supply or the decrease in supply. Before we move on to the next slide, I've got an exciting quiz lined up for you today. So after you've given a best shot at it, I highly encourage you to share your responses in these comment sections below. Your answers are really valuable, so do not hesitate to join in and share your thoughts. Always remember, together we can learn and grow. So let's see the question. So this is a question. How does the cost-saving technology affect the equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity? Option A, equilibrium price decreases and equilibrium quantity also decreases. Option B, equilibrium price decreases and equilibrium quantity rises. Option C, both equilibrium price and quantity would fall. And option D is the opposite, both equilibrium price and quantity would rise. Try to avoid any oral or memory based solutions. Draw the diagram and see what is the total impact on the equilibrium quantity and price. It'll be a cakewalk if you draw the diagram, and just jot down your answers in the comments. All right. If you find my videos useful, please do like and subscribe to my channel. That would help me in a great deal. Let's move on to the next slide. So this is a case where you would see an increase in demand smaller than a decrease in supply. So in this case, you would see the demand curve shifting to the right by a smaller amount compared to the supply curve shifting to the left. So this means that the equilibrium price would again rise and the quantity would fall. But how did we arrive at it? So when we talk about the effect on price, we see that there's a substantial decrease in supply compared to an increase in demand. This would again lead to a shortage scenario in the market, and by far we should be aware that any shortage scenario would put an upward pressure on the prices. So what is the impact on the quantity? We see that the quantity in this particular market has gone down. And this is simply because a lot of buyers may find it difficult to buy this commodity at such a high price. And in this case, people would restrain from buying this commodity, and hence the equilibrium quantity would fall. So what is the overall impact on price? The prices have gone up from PE to P1, whereas quantity has gone down from QE to Q1. And why has this occurred? Because an increase in demand was smaller than a decrease in supply. So with this, we come to an end to our series on simultaneous changes in demand and supply and how that impacts the equilibrium price and quantity in a given market. All right, students, that marks the end of this series. I'll meet you next in another video with another topic. Until then, take care. Bye now.